My name's Jono Adams, and I'm a mathematics teacher, and I teach years 11 and 12. I've got quite a broad range of classes and different abilities of kids in my classes, working with different ability levels, and I really have to think about how I can present concepts in different ways and get kids to engage different levels. A lot of mathematics teaching can be very textbook and very routine. And so something that I really try to do with all my classes is get them to develop a deeper understanding about why do certain processes. So for example, I like to use a lot of technology in my classes. The great advantage of technology is they can do lots and lots of examples very, very quickly. So I guess technology comes into its own where it makes life easier in terms of calculations and frees our brains up to think about why, not just be thinking about doing the process. There's a free software program, GeoGebra, that we were using yesterday, which you can download, and it can basically construct any diagram, any picture that you could draw on a board. Anything that I would normally in the old days have done with chalk and a ruler on the whiteboard, or on the blackboard rather, I can do on that software program. I can have it up in an instant and I can change it immediately and everything will change.
Let's have a look. If I make it negative, okay, it's happened pretty quick there, but you can sort of see it's going the opposite direction.
And that's a really powerful tool, because often the concepts that I'm trying to communicate from my diagram, like imagine if this point moved here on my diagram, the kids don't have to imagine it anymore because I can click on that point and I can move it and they can see how that changes the diagram.
That's the equation of a straight line, okay? So it's really, you can sort of see that there. If I drop the x squared term down to zero, then I'm left with just a linear function.
To be able to show what's happening visually and get them to get an idea for, okay, what should the result of this be? Let's see if we can show that with the algebra. And trying to develop the two in parallel is something that technology makes a lot easier than has been in the past. I think they're definitely more engaged, and they ask a lot more what if questions.
Y-intercept is 86.
Okay.
Now obviously my axes are a bit out here, but that's it.
One more equation has to equal zero.
Excellent. Okay. Two factors here multiplied together, the answer is zero. There's a couple of different cases we can have with parabolas. This is the first case where we have two unique solutions. Okay, this is case number two, where we have a single solution. What's the third case?
No
x-intercepts at all, okay? And to show that...
I guess there's sort of an excitement when people see what you're doing in the classroom and they go, oh, I'd like to learn how to do that as well. And pretty quickly, I was helping other people to use it as well. And here in this environment, where we're very technology rich, everyone wants to be using it, and we've got open classrooms so everyone can sort of see what you're doing and asks what I've taught them some basics, and even just in the last couple of weeks I've seen other teachers using it and then doing things that I didn't know that you could do with the software that I haven't happened to discover. So I'm actually learning from them and they're learning from me. I don't ever want to be a teacher that doesn't stop learning and doesn't stop adapting and doesn't stop developing and changing the way that I'm doing things. And I think technology really forces you to be thinking outside the box. And I mean, it starts with small steps, and originally I wasn't doing much more than using it to draw a diagram and save me some time drawing in the classroom. But then as I've become more familiar with the technology and more comfortable with its use, I guess I'm confident in expanding more and more and more with its use. And I'm really excited at seeing how that might change in the future and what might be possible.
What processes do you use in selecting, trialing and recommending relevant and appropriate ICT software in your school? How can teachers who don't work in open classrooms achieve improved teacher collaboration?